Good morning, students. Hi, this is Professor Vipul Shah here, and today I'm having an orientation with you with respect to how is going to be your journey post 10th standard if you're planning to take engineering as one of your fields in life. This will, by the time this entire clip gets over, I want everyone to have a clear senses and a clear goal. Okay, how is going to be your roadmap with respect to engineering and how well you're going to frame your future. I wish all of you all the best and good luck. Okay, let's start. Okay. First of all, what is the agenda for this orientation? We need to understand this part few things very clearly over here. Okay, initial part only. After 10th standard, how is going to be your 11th and 12th standard? Post 11th and 12th standard, which will be the science stream in the colleges. What are the examinations like MHT, CET? The JEE examination, which will be the mains and the advanced examinations, and what are the other entrance examinations, which are the engineering colleges, and which are the various promising fields, you know, which can give you a better path ahead. Now, first of all, after 10th standard, you'll be taking up the 11th and the 12th standard, that's your board exam, all right? Now, with respect to the boards, how it is? You'll be having vocational science. I hope everybody is aware about the word vocational subjects or the word bifocal subjects. So we'll be talking about that with respect to the HSC boards. Then we have MHT CET, that's the Maharashtra state level examination for the engineering colleges and the pharmacy colleges in Maharashtra. The admission route will be through MHT CET. Then we have the JEE mains and the JEE advanced. These are mainly to the IITs. The national level examination we have, and through JEE mains we also have the NIITs and the IIITs also. That also we'll discuss, and we'll also discuss about the various other entrance examinations we have, because at engineering there are many colleges which are autonomous. They themselves over there have their own universities, so they conduct their own examinations, and how well they are affected with respect to the current, you know, whatever is the working going on around the worldwide. How these autonomous colleges work. We'll get an input about that also. All right, let's start the first parameter, 11-12 science. So I want all the students, please have a clear mind how the entire work is gonna be, okay? Now post your 10th standard results, which will be now coming in the month of May, June. I think some examinations are left. So post that when your 11th and 12th curriculum starts, your subjects are gonna be like this. You people will have four compulsory subjects. That's one is physics, one is chemistry, one is maths, and one is English. Now, people who are very sure to take up engineering as the stream in life, and very simple, you have an option. You can remove the second language. And how is that? You can opt for vocational subject. That's also called a bifocal subject. Now, there are some 5-6 courses, but the main ones in vocational subjects or bifocal subjects are, one is computer science, second one is electronics, and third is electrical maintenance. Now apart from this, you have scooter repairing also. There are many different vocational subjects, but these are the main three which are offered with most of the colleges. All right, now with this vocational subject taken, the benefit will be, it's a 200 mark paper. So one, the second language is out, which can be either Hindi or French. And along with that, also biology is out. So if you're very clear that you want to go only in the engineering stream and you want to opt for bio, then you can take up vocational subjects. If you don't want to take vocational, you can keep the regular subjects. So with regular, four subjects, that will be maths, physics, chem, and bio. Maths, physics, chem, and bio. Then you'll have English and you will have your second language. So total six papers. Here also, four compulsory, PCM, English, and bifocal, which is a 200 mark paper there. Okay, we'll discuss this. So this is one parameter clear, everyone, the 11-12 science. So out of the one, if you want to keep, for example, you want to do biomedical engineering, there you require biology. So in that case, you'll have to keep bio in your 12th standard, then you can't take the bifocal, you have to take the regular subjects. But if you want to do computer science, information technology, IT, mechanical, and you're clear, biology is not your forte, or you are not made for bio, and in that case, you can go for these vocational subjects, because These subjects are the ones which are very scoring subjects. On 200 mark paper, students sometimes gets 190, 195 marks. In fact, I can say if you work properly, 180 plus is not gone anywhere. So your overall percentage really shoots up a lot, which helps for your admissions for MS abroad. Okay, we'll see that. Next, coming to the parameter now, your HSE boards, how it works. You have PCM, physics, chemistry and maths, which is a 100 mark paper, what we have. But in the 100 mark, we have practicals for 20 marks, 10 marks is your project, and 70 mark is a theory paper. And the theory paper has MCQs, multiple choice question, with any one option correct. You have answered in one sentence, then you have give reasons, you have short answers, numericals to solve, and long answers. So the paper is broadly classified over there. Alright, so you are supposed to get in each of them, physics, chemistry and maths, a decent of 50%. Now this 50%, mind you, is an eligibility weightage. Now when I stress on this word, eligibility weightage, you're not supposed to work only for 50% marks. At least a decent 85 to 90% is what you should try to score. Because for any subject, if my concepts are good, so if my HRC PCM is 90% and above, then correspondingly, whichever entrance exam I give, I'm definitely going to work better for it. In fact, my concepts are better, I'll be able to perform better. So 50% is the eligibility. Please catch the word. It's only eligibility. If you're taking bifocal, that's the vocational subjects. And for vocational, you have two papers, as I told you, which are of 100 marks each. All right. And you have your English paper, which is another 100 marks. That's it. But if you're not taking this, as I rightly said in the previous part, if you're planning to take up biomedical engineering, then you require biology. Then for biology, in that case, you will have PCM, you'll have bio, 100 marks, you'll have English, 100 marks, and you'll have a second language that also will be 100 marks. So total 600 marks. Okay, so this is the concept with respect to HSE. Now coming to the examination, Maharashtra CET, that is the MH CET examination, as I told. So 11th, 12th you will be studying, and along with that, we will also prepare you for the entrance exams. Now in the entrance examination, the first part comes Maharashtra CET, which is for all government and private colleges in Maharashtra for engineering and pharmacy. This examination is for two things, engineering and pharmacy. Let's see, it's a 200 mark paper where right now the current scheme is, you have maths 50 questions which are of 2 marks each, so that comes to 100. Where separately you are given the maths paper for 1 hour. And physics you have 50 MCQs which is for 1 mark, so that comes to 50. And chemistry is 50 MCQs which is also for 1 mark, which is also 50. So total we have 200 mark paper where maths is 1 hour, physics and chemistry together. If it is a normal paper which was a pen and pencil based paper, then it is the timing limit over there is maths paper, which goes for not 1 hour, it goes for over there nothing but the maths paper over there for 1 hour, and the physics and chemistry paper also goes for 1 hour. But if it is an online paper, then the online paper is a 3 hour paper, what you have, where all the three will come together, that is maths, physics and chemistry, and you get 3 hours to complete the entire paper. Okay, so here there's a mistake there, it won't be 1-1, it's going to be 3 hours total to complete the PCR. So this is one Maharashtra CET examination where getting into the top colleges, your percentile ranking has to be minimum 95 percentile. If it is around 95 percentile, you will make it to the top engineering colleges. Okay, this is one. Then comes the next exam, that is what we call as the JEE examination, which is for the IITs, the IIITs and the NITs. Now this paper is a 300 mark paper, where the paper pattern keeps on changing. Right now, 2020, this is what the pattern is. You have maths 25 questions, each of 4 marks, so total is 100. Same as physics and same as chemistry. So total, the child has to attempt 75 questions, each of 4 marks. So the total, when we put it up over there, and that's going to be over there, 300 marks. Where? Out of the 25 questions, 5 questions are going to be numerical types. Now, when I say numerical type questions, meaning what? They are the questions without the options, and the answer to those questions will be only with numbers up to 2 decimal places, what you mark. So numerical based will only have the question without options. It's basically the answer will be numbers up to two decimal places, like a problem. And this will not have any negative marking also. So the negative marking will be only on the 20 questions, not on these last 5 questions. Clear, everybody? So 25 questions for each, so that's 75 questions. Each one, maths, physics, and chemistry, will have 5 questions which will be numerical types. So for numerical type questions, we will have over there nothing but there'll be no options and there'll be no negative marking. So that's the part. Here also you get 3 hours to solve. So it's a 3 hour to solve all 3 subjects. 5 questions in each one are numerical types. This is the pattern they have started for this year, that is 2020. And that will be without negative marking, what we have. So that's the pattern. And this JEE examination percentile, what will come, which also should be a good percentile of 95 percentile above to get into the IIITs and the NITs. Then, next comes, after JEE, if you are very keen to get only into IIT and you have desired, I want to become an engineer from IIT, then you are supposed to give, you know, give the IIT. That's the, for IIT, you have to give the JEE advanced. So in the JEE mains, once you qualify, the qualifying percentile comes every year, which is somewhere around 80-85 percentile what comes. That's the main, you know, it varies every year. Last year it was around some 80 percentile, so I'm giving a rough idea. Whatever is the percentile, what suppose your scores are higher, you are 95 percentile, then you are, after JEE main, you are qualified for the JEE advance. And you have a gap of nearly 8 weeks, meaning 2 months for the examination between the JEE mains and the JEE advanced. Now what is this JEE advanced? Again, 3 papers, that is basically 3 subjects. So 2 papers are there of 3 hours each, that is maths, physics, and chemistry. And here the questions are in different concepts, meaning they are, first of all, question which includes MCQ based, which includes only one option correct or more than one option correct. There are comprehension based questions, matrix matching, matlab match the column types, integer types, integer based questions, matlab answer can be anywhere between 0 to 9 that way, assertion and reasoning questions, and numerical value types. So these are the different parameters on which the JEE advanced paper is based. The concept is the same, but the question paper and the way the paper is set up is more on analytical thinking. So if a child develops analytical thinking, then definitely this is what will, you know, really change the entire focus. So these are the types. So we'll be making the children do these practices also, we'll give them. So if a child tomorrow qualifies for the mains, but obviously you should give it a shot for advance. You never know, you may click. Now, negative marks, there's negative marking for the wrong answers, and there is partial marking also for multiple correct options. Now, the examination, this paper format is not fixed. It keeps on changing every year, and the marking schemes keeps on changing. So that's how it is. Okay. This is one about JEE Advanced, precisely for the IITs. Then, next examination, what you can give, because the syllabus, what you will be doing in all, like say, for example, Maharashtra's ET. The portion right now for the 2020 paper, it is the 12th standard portion and 11th standard few chapters are only there. But 12th standard, there are 40 questions and 11th standard few chapters, there are only 10 questions. Most likely, you know, for next year, that is what I'm talking is 2021. They may come up with a, you know, scheme over there where it will be full 11th and full 12th, like the JEE main pattern. JEE main is complete NCRT of 11th and 12th. Where both are of equal weightage, questions are asked, they are supposed to know both 11th and 12th. Now with that NCRT, we can also give this examination, which is the next equivalent to IIT, that's BITSAT. I hope everybody is aware of this name, BITS. That's the Birla Institute of Technology, which is Pilani, Goa and Hyderabad, where their paper pattern, the portion is same, NCRT 11th and 12th, 40 MCQs for physics, another 40 for chem. And part 3 is made up of 2 parts, where there is English proficiency is observed with 15 questions and a logical reasoning is there with 10 questions. And part 4 is maths, which is of 45 questions. So this is how the 4 parts in which the, you know, in the BITSAT paper is set. The marking scheme is, it's plus 3 for every correct answer and a minus 1 for a wrong answer. And these papers are all online papers, which you can give it in Mumbai also. So the dates and all of all these examinations are somewhere around December. So suppose a child is appearing for, as I am saying, say for May 2022, then somewhere around December 21 or November or December 21, these colleges will come out with their, they basically advertise in the newspapers or on the net or something. We get an idea that they come out with their admission process. Examinations are all online and they are given, centers are throughout. So you can give it in Bombay itself, you know, this examination, and then you can keep this as an option, because tomorrow after IIT, the next equivalent is BITS only. Okay, so this is about the BITSAT exam. Next examinations, what are there? The various other examinations, because with engineering, you'll be giving 6 to 7 various examinations. One is the, now colleges wise, one is the government colleges that is affiliated with respect to the colleges, one affiliated to the Mumbai University, which offers you BE, that's Bachelor of Engineering, and some affiliated which are autonomous, which offers you BTech, Bachelor of Technology. So colleges which are autonomous, they have their own examinations. I'm just discussing some of them over here. Like, look at this. SET E, that's an examination by KJ Somaya, that is for KJ Somaya Vidya Vihar Engineering College. It's become autonomous from 2020. So this is their paper pattern, where physics is 50. All right. Then maths is 50 MCQs and total 150. That's the pattern what they have, where MCQs 200 marks is what the paper pattern is. All right, that is one of KJ Somaya. Second, we have NPAT, that is of the, I hope everybody's heard the name, NMIMS, that is the Narsimhoji Institute, what is there? That is the Mukesh Patel College of Engineering. There it has got physics, chemistry, maths, each 30 MCQs. And then you have logic intelligence, that is the 20 MCQs. And you have the language proficiency with respect to English. So total 120 MCQs with respect to 120 marks. That's the NPAT. Then we have MET, that's the Manipal Engineering College. That is the Karnataka border what we have. It's one of the Asia's best to get into. Then we have VIT, that is the Vellore Institute, one of the best where Microsoft has placements. So a very good college to get into, which is at Chennai, Bhopal and Andhra Pradesh. Then we have the SRM, that is the SRM University in Chennai. That is also one of the best. So these are some of the examinations which we can keep it as a backup. So what I want is, today after this orientation gets over, you can just frame up your mind, okay, what options we can keep. Because at engineering stream, yes, you have a lot of options. You can give the MHCT, you can give the JEE, you can give these entrance examination. So you have a variety of options to select which field you wanna get into, okay? Then, normal engineering coming to, how is it? It's a 4-year course. So let's put up, by the time you complete your 11th and 12th, you're gonna be 18. So 18 plus 4. At 22, if you are doing it from a private autonomous college, then the degree will be BTech, that's Bachelor of Technology. If you are doing it affiliated to the Mumbai University, then you will get the degree as BE, Bachelor of Engineering. Then some of the popular streams we have, that's Computer Science, one of the hotcakes, IT, the Information Technology, EXTC, that's Electronics and Telecommunication over there. So some of the most important part. Then very selected streams, Mechanical, that's the mother of all engineering. Production, which is a sister concern with respect to mechanical, and chemical engineering with respect to all chemical plants, all right, mainly the oil industry over there. And some unique is what I was discussing in the beginning, people who want to pursue with biomedical engineering, some unique streams, great demand, which is abroad. Biomedical is basically instruments, all these, the MRI scan machines and all what we have in hospitals, built by JEE, Siemens and all. They require all these biomedical engineers. So great demand. Aeronautical is also there, as well as we can go for civil. So these are some of the fields what we have. Then coming to engineering people, first we have the IITs, as I said, that is to the JEE Mains and Advanced, where we have 16 IITs, where for the IIT to get in, the scores accepted are of the JEE Advanced, where HSC minimum, now see for normal JEE Mains, all right, you are a 50%, you are 50% to get in your PCM in your 12th. For advanced part to get into the IIT, your HSE has to be 75%. So if it is 75%, then only. That was 50, here it is 75, okay? And the cutoffs, depending upon which location and which stream, you're selecting depending on that. So that's one idea about the IITs. Second is about the NIITs. We have 31 different types of IITs over there, where for NIITs and triple IITs, you don't have to give the JEE Advanced. It's only through the JEE main score. So if your JEE main score sometimes is like 98 or 99 percentile, then you have a clear-cut red carpet to get into any of the NIITs and any of the triple IITs over there. That's one. Same with the triple IITs. We have around 25 locations. And again, you can enter through the JEE main score. So we have basically, to get an idea, we have first after 10th, the 11th and the 12th to go through the science part. Then we have MHT CET, that's for Maharashtra. Then you have JEE part to give, where JEE will be with respect to the IITs part, what we have. And if you're able to clear that, then you have the IIT Advance over there. The JEE Advance is there for the IITs. You have the NIITs through the JEE main. You have the triple IITs. You have BITSAT to give with the NCRT portion, what we are going to teach you for 11th and 12th. You also have, along with BITSAT, that is the NMIMS examination, the KJSOMA examination, the VIT, the Manipal, the SRM. You have a big, you know, bang over there of all the respected, the most autonomous and the one of the best institutes to get into engineering. All right, so this is one. Now, giving an idea to you about the colleges. VGTI, everybody is aware, one of the oldest colleges and most popular colleges. There it is through MHT CET, it happens. It's an autonomous, government autonomous. Then we have SPC, that's the second best, or SPIT, that's the Sardar Patel College of Engineering. Again, one of the most reputed. There also it's through MHCET. That's also government, but it is autonomous. Then KJSOMAYA, that is, again, the examination SETI, which I discussed. It's a private one, but it's autonomous, so it has its own entrance. DJ Sanghvi from 2020 has become autonomous. And plus, I've just put an asterisk to get an idea. In KJSOMAYA, DJ Sanghvi, both these are Gujarati managements. So as there are Gujarati managements, we have the Gujarati quota for them. So 50% seats are reserved with respect to Gujaratis over there. That's one. Then we have the Mukesh Patel. That's the NMIMS. All right. That with the examination is NPAT. That's a private university on its own. Then we have ICT. That's the Institute of Chemical Engineering. That is nothing but the earlier name was UDCT. One of the most reputed colleges to do chemical engineering from here. Here also the admissions is based on MHCET, as well as we also have certain 10 to 15% admissions are on the basis of JEE main marks also. But it keeps varying every year. It's not fixed. Mainly is on MHCET and some quota is with respect to JEE main. Then we have TSEC, what we call as Thadomal Shani Engineering College, which is in Bandra Linking Road. Here also it is through MHCET. And here also, here we have a minority institute. You have 50% seats which are reserved for Sindhis over there. Again, KJSOMAYA signed, that's the one more branch. You have two KJSOMAYA. One is the Vidya Vihar and the second one is signed. There also you have MHCET marks. In fact, from this year, you will also be going through the SETI exam. And it is again over there, nothing but. This is also one of the latest institutes to add into it. Then we have Vidyalankar, which is again having MHCET. You have Shah and Anchor. There are a lot of colleges which are available. Where for Shah and Anchor, you have the Kachi quota. So depending upon the college, whatever is the management, they have certain reserved quotas. All right. Which as you pursue, we'll be discussing about it. Then to get an idea about, I'm keeping talking about autonomous university. What's the difference between the two? It's always advisable to get into the autonomous because you'll be in pace with what's going on worldwide. And that's going to enhance your knowledge. And tomorrow when you step into the industry, you will be on your toes as you enter. Now, autonomous, you're awarded with BTEC. Here it is a B. Here the syllabus is as per the latest trend, whereas Bombay University will have the syllabus which has been going on or prescribed as per the university. Exams are conducted by the college management itself. Whereas here the examinations are by Mumbai University. You go through the regular semester pattern, where every 4 years, matlab 6 months semester pattern, so 4 into 2. So you will have 8 semesters to clear, where every semester you will have your GPA score, and depending on the GPA score, which is from 0 to 10, if it is 8 and above, that is considered to be the best. Then here the difficulty level is, it's difficult to get into and it's high scores, whereas here the cutouts are quite low. then here the placements are much better, whereas here the placements, I'm like, for example, in autonomous, the placements are really, like, for example, if you observe VIT, Microsoft does placements where the package is somewhere around 35 to 40 lakhs per annum. So you can imagine at an age of 20 to 23, when you're coming out and you're having such high packages being given over there. So it depends if you're from an autonomous university. As I said, you are on your toes. And fees-wise, yes, the autonomous colleges are a little expensive, whereas these are comparatively cheaper. Like, for example, the Bombay University fees might be somewhere around 1.2 to 1.3 lakhs per year, whereas the autonomous might be around 2.5 to 3 lakh rupees per year. It keeps varying every year, but we need to see how it is. So entire idea is, as we go ahead, autonomous is always better. Okay. Now, what are the engineering streams? Quick recap now. One is computer science, that is the most promising stream over there, which is hardware as well as software, which has the highest placements awards what we have. These are the colleges which have these this computer science over there, one of the top fields to get into and the most demanding. Then second, we have IT, which is a sister concern, where computer science was hardware and software, whereas IT is only software over there. And here also the placements are very good. And all these colleges, the IIT, the VCTI, the DJ Sanghvi, KJ Samaya, SPIT, all of them are there. Then next we have is the EXTC, that's the Electronics and Telecommunications and Electronics over there. That's the part over there. Where here, what it says, here also the placements are quite good and there's a good scope after the graduations. Now, after this normal BTech or the BE gets over, what is the scope with respect to further studies? We'll discuss that also. Next, we have mechanical, that's, as I told you, that's the mother of all engineering, so which is always one of the best. Next, we have biomedical. I told you the biomedical part is mainly the instruments. That's the whatever are used in the hospitals. That scope is with respect to biomed. Then we have production engineering, which is a sister concern with respect to mechanical, where mechanical engineering, a sister concern part, where specific production, if you want to get into, then this is the field that will be of very good help. Now, after engineering, the last part to discuss. One is to take up a job or to pursue MBA, because there are two options. One, after completing your BE or BTech, you pursue with MBA by giving an examination of CAT, that is the common entrance test, and you pursue 2 years with respect to either finance or with HRD. There are various fields that you can take it up. And job prospects are really nice if you're getting, because there you will be clearing the CAT and getting through the IIMs, or you'll be getting it through the Bajaj Institute or through the XLRI Institutes. There are loads of them with respect to management. So that is one. Or second option, you can pursue with masters, where you can do your MS with respect to all the possible countries in the world, that is the US, UK, Canada and all. So basically, to sum it up, you have 4 years of 11th, 12th, first after 10th. So right now you're 16 years old, so 16 plus 2, 18. At 18, your engineering starts, so that's another 4 years. So that's going to be around 22, you're done with your engineering. Post 22, you take up an MBA for 2 years, or you do your MS, which is also for another 2 years. So maybe by 24, 25, you are out in the market. Right now with abroad, students who are pursuing and completing their MS, they are very sincere, hardworking, dedicated. The pay packets are nearly 150 to 200,000 US dollars. This is the annual packages what is being offered. So scope-wise, engineering rocks. It's a very good field to get into it. Only thing is, make yourself totally determined. As you go ahead, you're going to rock it. So you won't have any issues to it. Okay? Thank you, everybody. I hope you have liked it. And this has given you some idea about how engineering is going to be or how it can help you to shape your career. Thank you very much. Thank you.